Almost half of the population worldwide does not produce enough vitamin D. Sun exposure is just not enough. The problem is, most people miss the signs that their body needs more vitamin D. That's really dangerous. Lack of vitamin D can cause a lot of problems. There are 7 signs everybody should know to fix a lack of vitamin D. Top 7 warning signs your body needs more vitamin D. In this video, I'll show you 7 signs that your body needs more vitamin D. The last sign can be life-threatening, so don't miss it. I'll also show you why vitamin D causes those signs, how to measure vitamin D, and how to fix this problem. Spoiler alert, it involves vitamin K2 and calcium. Number 1, memory and mood problems. Are you starting to forget things? Well, vitamin D might be involved. Recent research has shown that vitamin D is essential to brain health. It improves axon regeneration. Axons are the nerve cells that make up the brain. Vitamin D reduces daily wear and tear on those brain neurons, helping them work more efficiently decade after decade. It also works as an antioxidant in the brain, reducing oxidative stress on those brain cells. Now you can see how a lack of vitamin D can impact your memory and mood. Vitamin D also regulates serotonin and dopamine. Remember, those are key neurotransmitters. Neurotransmitters and dysregulation of those, by the way, is yet another mechanism of vitamin D deficiency causing symptoms. Number 2, muscle tingling. We're talking about involuntary muscle spasms. Low vitamin D causes muscle tingling. This is actually due to low calcium. Vitamin D deficiency causes low levels of blood calcium. This is what happens. Another geek alert. Typically, 25-hydroxy vitamin D, the inactive form of vitamin D, in the bloodstream enters different cells, like immune cells and kidney cells, transforming them 125-hydroxy vitamin D. That's the active form of vitamin D. Pay attention to the names here. Calcitriol sounds like calcium, right? Calcitriol binds to various organ tissues, such as the kidneys, parathyroid glands, intestines, and bones. It promotes calcium release from the bone into the bloodstream. So this is the connection. Low vitamin D causes low calcium. Now, what causes the muscle tingling? Well, for the muscles to contract or relax, they need calcium. A lack of calcium can cause the muscle to have a rough transition between contraction and relaxation, causing muscle tingling or spasms. It's like a car engine with a faulty spark plug. Number 3, dry skin. If you already use a lot of moisturizers, consider checking your vitamin D levels. Skin is necessary to create vitamin D. Thanks to sunlight, the skin is capable of converting, geek alert, 7-dehydrocholesterol, it's just a precursor of vitamin D, into pre-vitamin D3, and then into D3, which can be stored in fat or converted into 25-hydroxy. Remember, that's the inactive vitamin D, and that happens in the liver. However, the skin also needs vitamin D for its health as well, the skin's health. 125-hydroxy vitamin D, the active form, and calcium are essential in skin renewal. Vitamin D also improves the immune response in the skin, and it even protects the skin from the sun. Dry skin can be a reflection of skin that's getting significant damage and cannot protect itself. Number 4, waddling walking. That is, walking like a duck. This brings me back to muscles and bones and joints. Severe hip arthritis and spine injuries can cause this more often. But low vitamin D can also be a reason. Remember, low vitamin D levels cause low calcium levels. In severe cases, low vitamin D and the resulting low calcium can even significantly weaken muscles and create weak hip bones. The weak bones condition is called osteomalacia, or low calcium levels in the blood, again, cause that weak bones, osteomalacia. Number five, fatigue. There are a lot more common causes of fatigue, from anemia to low thyroid. But it's recently become very clear that low vitamin D can also cause fatigue. A very recent study is now showing how vitamin D deficiency does this. Here's how. Vitamin D is necessary to decrease oxidative stress. It reduces nitric oxide synthase. Remember our visit with Dr. No, Lou Ignaro? This is the enzyme that makes nitric oxide. And if you don't remember nitric oxide, you can find out all about it on that video. Another technical word alert. Be patient for just a second. Two more technical words. They're coming up. Cyclooxygenase 2 and nuclear factor kappa. Here's why those are important. Both of these cause oxidative stress, inflammation, and you got it, fatigue. Number six, bone and joint pain. The best bones you've ever had were when you were 30. Over time, aging takes a toll, and bones will become more and more fragile. But you can slow this down. Vitamin D deficiency is a big culprit. As you've seen already, low vitamin D causes low calcium. And you know what happens to bones and joints with low calcium. We call that demineralization. The minerals come out. They lose their strength and calcium, making them fragile. This is called osteoporosis. Vitamin D stimulates the synthesis of another geek word, proteoglycan. Now that word, proteoglycan, is important because it's essential for maintaining appropriate joint cushioning. It's the shock absorber fluid in the joint. So, if you're in your 40s or older and deal with bone and joint pain, consider vitamin D. As we say, test, don't guess. Number seven, and this is a critical one. This is a sign you need to look for because if you have it, it can be life-threatening. It can kill you. I'm talking about cardiovascular plaque. Now, this is not new information, but a recent article reviewed the evidence yet again behind the relationship between vitamin D deficiency and arterial plaque. Here's what happens. Vitamin D has significant anti-inflammatory, antioxidant, and immune-modulating functions. Now, why is that important? Vitamin D can decrease the amount of two very inflammatory substances. You may have heard of them, TNF-alpha and IL-6, tissue necrosis factor alpha and interleukin-6. But you don't need to remember those names. You just need to remember that these are two major actors in arterial plaque buildup. It's no wonder why people with low vitamin D develop more arterial plaque. How can you know that you have plaque? Well, there are multiple tests. Let's list them real quick. Calcium score, CIMT, carotid intermediate thickness test, coronary CT angiogram, CT angiogram, and if you get that, get the one with the AI analysis, artificial intelligence. You can even get some information about plaque right at home by measuring the blood pressure of your arms and your ankles and comparing that using some standards. We'll show you exactly how to do that in another video. Let's stop for a minute and talk more about vitamin D testing.
Pardon the interruption, but I've got something important to tell you. If you're tired of your current cardiovascular prevention care and are looking for help, call us 859-721-1414. Become a patient and get the level of care that you deserve. Now let's get back to that video.
I told you earlier that there are two types of vitamin D in the bloodstream, the inactive form, 25-hydroxy, and the active form, 1,25-hydroxy. It's got another hydroxy or oxygen and hydrogen in that one position. It may sound intuitive to measure only the active form, but both are important and you should test for both. Vitamin D behaves a lot like a hormone. It has a special attraction to fat. Now, here's why that matters. You can get lower serum vitamin D levels with weight gain, and vice versa. It also impacts test result interpretations. Most labs consider deficiency at 25-hydroxy vitamin D levels below 30 nanograms per milliliter. However, the Endocrine Society, the National and International Osteoporosis Foundation, and the American Geriatric Society all recommend levels between 40 and 60. They're looking for 40 and above. I recommend levels even a tiny bit higher, 50. Why? Levels below 50 have been shown to increase the risk of cardiovascular plaque buildup. And, you know, we're all about plaque, because that's what kills you. High levels of vitamin D above 100 can cause multiple problems and even death. Levels above 100 can injure the kidney. The risk is higher with high calcium levels and dehydration. I do recommend supplementation, usually 5,000 international units once daily, and no more than 10,000 international units. However, I only recommend supplementation while measuring vitamin D levels. Also, remember the impact of body fat? Vitamin D levels in the blood might increase as you lose weight and decrease as you gain weight. Let's move on to K2. Vitamin K2 has a significant role. A recent meta-analysis, a study of studies, has shown that when combining vitamin K2 supplementation with vitamin D, mineral bone density can increase. Let me repeat that. Combining K2 supplementation with vitamin D, you can get mineral bone density increase. Some evidence suggests that vitamin D3, with the right amounts of vitamin K2, can activate a substance called matrix GLA protein, or MGP. MGP might be able to bind to calcium and remove it from places where it's just not supposed to be, like artery walls and other soft tissues. However, calcium might help stabilize plaque. So let's not focus quite so much on reducing or taking calcium out of our artery wall. Instead, let's focus on reducing inflammation from those arteries. Fortunately, vitamin K2 can help with that as well. So I recommend 400 micrograms of vitamin K2 once a day as a safe supplement. Remember, lifestyle is by far more important in preventing heart attacks and strokes. Lifestyle is king. You cannot out-supplement a lifestyle. If you want to know how else to unclog your arteries, check out the top 7 foods that clean them.